defense. They're gonna take half.
Oh! That's 7-all.
Yes, again!
Love it.
Yes, again!
Oh, shit. Game art.
What was the first point? Who started Oak? Do you remember?
Zig.
Zig 3 started offense.
Oi! Where's that Nick?
Get some air, man. Nick!
Hello and welcome to the 2017 Australian Ultimate Championships here in beautiful Runaway Bay on the Gold Coast. Apologies for the delay getting the stream up and going, but we're live now. We're joining the match between Sid Fury from Adelaide and the Chch out of Christchurch, New Zealand. I'm Max, and I'll be keeping you company for this game, and alongside me, I'll let him introduce himself.
My name is Scott McKenzie. And it is a lovely day here at the Gold Coast. It's a bit windy, but we are really set up for a good game of Ultimate.
So to bring you up to date, we've got a slight wind going away from the camera towards the right as well a little bit. And it's currently 7-all. To bring you up to date, the team's traded till Zikuri was up 4-3 before going on a 4-point run to take it to 7-3. And the Chch Chicks have just responded with 4 straight points. Bring it back to 7-all. So we've had swings of momentum throughout this game so far, and it seems like it's going to be a good one.
Alright, New Zealand brimming with confidence. Throw down a nice pull, just makes the brick mark. Maiolo picking up the disc, checking the disc now at the moment. For a swing across to Maiolo. Maiolo back to Cheng. Cheng looking deep, puts the disc up. Rosler picking up the disc, great grab over the defense from New Zealand. Back to Cheng, swinging across to the break side to Maiolo. Looking upfield. Nice dump cut from T. Nice break throw to Stringer. And the defense by New Zealand.
Christensen there getting the D. We saw New Zealand, the Chch Chicks, transition from a zone at the start of that point to a match defense. It's the first time we've seen that transition this game. With Bilak picking up the disc now. Operating out of a horizontal stack. Bailey working hard. Can't quite get open.
Nice bid there from Colbert. And then it looks to be Cheng walking up to the disc with T set up as the dump. Got a...
Wow, Weatherall, great hands to get that block. Chch looking to move it quickly, find Christensen on the sideline. Back to Bilek. To Christensen, loses the cap. Looks to Jones, but the wind gets underneath it and it floats up and away and out the sideline.
Yeah, this wind is really punishing any throws that aren't being held flat. So we've got Chang picking up the disc on the sideline. Punting it deep, looking for Rosler. Rosler's trying to find it. New Zealand picks it up.
Well read there. Immediately looks to Bailey, but Billett cleans up the scraps to Weatherall. To Billett again. Billett's been getting a lot of discs throughout this game. Jones, back to Weatherall. Oh, feathery flick into the end zone. And that is the Chicks taking half 8-7 after going on a 5-point unanswered run. 8-7.
Brimming with confidence, this New Zealand team. They are looking really good at the moment. They've figured out this wind. And definitely able to use their power from their handlers.
Yeah, absolutely. I think we saw earlier on, Zig Theory were the first to bring out their zone defense. And at first, the Chicks didn't have a response. And it took them a little while to figure out how to get through that zone, but they did. As Scott mentioned, their high-quality handlers and some very nice breakthroughs in the wind. I've seen them manage to adjust, change their game style a little bit. A few less deep looks and a little bit more quick handler movement has seen them find lots of success, as well as their own zone defense has got them 5 breaks in a row now, which is pretty impressive to take half.
I think that zone defense is where it's been for New Zealand. It's been a lot of high pressure. They've also changed it up a bit. They've gone from a pommy to shifting a point out and mucking that dump handler. So Zig Theory have really been struggling to find some players downfield and just to generate some flow.
Yeah, absolutely. So what do you think the Zig Theory leadership are saying to their team now in the huddle, trying to find a way to respond after having conceded 5 points in a row?
I reckon just try to stay positive from here on in. Zig Theory just need to keep their heads in it. They'd be running out of legs. They've had a couple of long points just searching for a player in the end zone. They've had it close off camera before we come on live. They made about 10, 15 passes, just about maybe 10 metres outside of that end zone, and they just could not find a player there. So I think just try and build some confidence between the team and hopefully their top-end players can just get them through.
And more of the same from the Chicks, or do you think they'll be looking to do something different in the second half?
Well, they've got the position. It's nearly their game to lose from here on in. I believe just keep what's working. Don't change it up. I guess they'll nearly wait for Zig Theory to make the next move, and they'll just keep putting these points in. They're coming out on offense, so it's another point, and the pressure's all on Zig Theory.
Yeah, absolutely. I guess when you get 5 in a row, you must be doing something right. No reason to change it unnecessarily. It's really exciting to have a New Zealand team over here. Doesn't happen every year, but when it does, it's always brings a bit of an unknown X factor. No one knows what to expect, both in terms of style and personnel. So it's good to see them coming over. I believe it's part of a long-term preparation for the next year's World Clubs, which I know that they've won a bid to. And they'll be representing the women's club scene in New Zealand very well. And this is part of their preparation for that tournament, I believe. For those wondering, throughout the week, we're playing games to 15, 100-minute games to 15. So really testing the endurance, the conditioning, the fitness, and the size of rosters that teams have brought. They're long games. So seeing how teams hold up throughout the week will be an interesting test for some teams that may be a little bit more used to the 90 or even 80-minute games of other tournaments. Having said that, both teams so far, I mean, it is the first morning of day one, but both teams so far showing lots of athleticism, running really hard. So hope to see more of that in the second half.
Yeah, this wind has, I reckon, been taken. It's taken a bit to get used to. New Zealand team, when they went 4 points down to Zig 3, who got a few breaks in a row, they had the power there. They just weren't quite able to hold on to catches. They weren't quite able to get those break throws off. But off camera, just before we came on, there was a beautiful, beautiful, brilliant inside out backhand break, 20 metre up the field through the zone. And the Kiwis just showing that they are a force to be reckoned with here at this tournament this weekend.
Yeah, absolutely. The likes of Emma Holdaway and Emily Camuso have been particularly potent with the disc in hand. Really showing a full toolbox of throws, breaking the mark, breaking through the zone, finding different angles, and it's led to a lot of the offensive movement from the Chch Chicks. And as we see now, their teams are getting back onto the line, getting ready to kick off the second half. We'll see what happens. Interesting to see here on the Chch Chicks O-line that they've brought Bilek across, who so far has played predominantly defense, and she's been one of their main pullers, has come across to the O-line, maybe to add a little bit of veteran know-how coming out of half to respond to any extra intensity or interesting defense that Zig Theory's got planned for them. We also see Emily Camuso, Eva Weatherall, and Emma Holdaway. We expect to see them getting a lot of the disc at this point.
All right, Enting Hawk, hands are up, disc is down.
And it's picked up by Holdaway. Swings to Bilek. Can't find Camuso underneath, swings back to Holdaway. We see just a normal match defense coming out of Zig Theory here. I think that's them saying we're going to win this with our legs. Holdaway struggling to find something she likes. Stall count getting high. High release backhand.
Good pressure from Zig Theory there.
And that's a turnover.
So we've got Thompson standing over the disc. Just picks it up. Looking upfield. Currently no movement. Enting Hawk making a play. Nice break throw from Thompson. Enting Hawk across the field. Unfortunate drop by Esley.
Holdaway picks up, looking to move it quickly. Bilek with the disc. Back to Holdaway. Strip call. Doesn't look like a lot of discussion. Oh, maybe there is a bit of disagreement. Coming in on zero, uncontested. Finds Weatherall coming underneath as the outlet. Back to Holdaway. Having to work hard to make upfield meters here. Oh,
nice. Interception. Getting the intercept. Got it back to Enting Hawk. Back to Dunmull. Making nice plays up the open side. Looking back in field. Nice dump cut from S. Lee. Brilliant. Right in front of the end zone here. Let's see if Zig Theory can capitalize. Not too much moving upfield though. Back to Dunmull. Back to S. Lee on that sideline. Enting Hawk. Looking for some movement in the end zone. And gets it to Battersby for the score.
That's a great goal from Zig Theory. We saw a really nice clearing upfield that allowed just them to isolate one player in the end zone, give them lots of space to work in. And when you've got players of the quality that Zig Theory have, you'll know they'll get open and they've got the throwers to hit them.
might be a little bit of the confidence kick that Zigdiri needed. Put that point in, they were really confident in doing it. And the defense looked good as well on man, so looks like we're going to have a close game here to finish it off for the second half.
Yeah, it's good to see that Zigdiri saying we're not about to roll over. We've got another shot to fire, something to respond to the New Zealand 5-point run. We should also say the wind comes and goes a bit. It's a bit gusty and it's just eased off for the moment, but I'm sure it'll be back. We saw a few throws that point where the wind just got underneath it a little bit, floated up over the intended receiver or out of reach, and it led to a couple of turns. So it's definitely impacting. But as we said, particularly some of the New Zealand handlers, but also some of the Zigdiri throwers do have the skills to get through it. And we've seen some nice throws despite the wind.
All right, so Thompson putting up the pull for Zigdiri.
Teo picking up, immediately centres to Meehan, across the field to Ha, wanting to play it up the fat side. Meehan, unfortunate, throw goes to ground.
Alright, so it looks like Zigdiri setting up in a vertical stack. Thompson walking towards the disc. Maiolo set up as the dump. They're quite deep here. Cut from Stringer, no dice. Dump cut from Maiolo. Opens up the space for Chang. Unfortunately, it's another turnover.
Meehan, the Irish import, picking up here. New Zealand really keen to try and play it on this upwind side of the field, which I think is a good move, but they find Christensen underneath to Jones. Fumble, but holds on. To Ha, just out of reach, can't quite get a full hand on that and close the hand.
Both defensive sides putting on a lot of pressure here for every throw. Cheng picking up the disc at the moment. Looking straight across to Thompson. There's a call.
Maybe been a contested down call, but
back to Thompson.
Staying with Thompson.
Alright, disc in. Thompson looking upfield. Rosler making a brilliant undercut. Back to Thompson. Upfield. Saved by Stringer. Good pull down. Harks up. Rosler. Oh, big dive from New Zealand. Rosler making a call.
Hold away. Coming out of nowhere, putting her body on the line, but there may have been some contact. Looks like an uncontested foul.
Quickly talked out between both sides. Rosler back to Thompson. Slightly on the open side, downwind. Straight into the end zone. We've got a pick call. Disc coming back to Thompson. Zigdiri have really stepped up here since halftime. They're really backing their legs at the moment, their athleticism. All right, so game on. Thompson to Evans for the score. Brilliant effort by Zigdiri. They really worked it up. Their downfield cutters really smoking the New Zealand defense there. But I don't think it'll be the last that we see of them, that's for sure.
Yeah, it's interesting that in the second half we've seen Zigdiri go back to playing match defense, as has the Chch Chicks, and it's seen a bit more success for Zigdiri. So, as you said, Scott, Zigdiri backing their legs, backing their athleticism, and so far it's paying dividends. The question is, can the Kiwis match them?
Hands are up from both teams. Enting Hawk with the disc. About to let rip for Zig Theory. And here we go.
Graham will bring it in on the brick mark. New Zealand setting up in a standard offensive stack. Vertical. Throws a little short of Chow. And it'll be a turnover.
Alright, so we've got T picking up the disc on the downwind sideline. Both teams have struggled to get off this sideline at times today. Straight away to Cheng. Nice upline cut. Looking back for the dump. T making a cut. Oh, Dumble coming in for the fill. Brilliant cut on the break side. Got it back to the centre with T. T looking upfield. Not a huge amount of movement aside from the handlers at the moment. Throws upwind to Cheng. Cheng, brilliant grab. Fingertips, there's a call. Might have just been a pick-up field, I think. Yep, just a pick call. All right, we're back in. Cheng with the disc.
Oh, big layout. Lots of contact.
All right. Uncontested foul. Esley with the disc. Brilliant upline cut again from Cheng. Looking for the power position throw. Nothing on. Looking for another dump. All right. Battersby comes in. Resets the count. Dunmore with the save. Another call.
Looks like we're getting a substitution here. Injury sub. Morgan Jones coming in. Let's play some defense.
All right, so disc coming in on zero with Dunmore. T making a good cut towards the sideline, getting closer to that end zone. This is where Zig Theory have struggled when they've lacked upfield movement. Oh!
Weatherall got a hand on it and still made the pass.
T got low, saved the disc. Enting Hawk coming up for a huge grab in front of the New Zealand defense. Both teams are really starting to lift here. T putting it into the end zone. Oh, and Michaela making a huge bid. Unfortunately, not coming down with it.
Had two goes at it, but the pressure was just too much and she couldn't complete the catch. That's a gift for New Zealand. Let's see if they can use it. Bilek will pick up. Bailey setting up in the dump space.
And that was time cap as well.
Back to Bilek. Weatherall gets horizontal but can't make the catch.
Important moments for both teams here. Cheng walking up to the disc. We've got T set up in the dump position. We've got Enting Hawk set right open in the open side. T making up the line. Well stopped by New Zealand. Enting Hawk also making a similar up the line cut. Puts it deep.
Morgan Jones reads it beautifully. Immediately looking deep to Weatherall. Weatherall working hard to get open in the end zone. Graham looking for Bilek, can't find her. Back to Weatherall. Weatherall doing a lot of work this point, going around to the fat side, finds Chow. That's 9-all, game to 10. 9-all, game to 10. Universe point, first game of the day. This is what we love to see it at Nationals.
This game has given us everything today. We've had a little bit of just only a slight breeze at the start of the game to half a cyclone through the middle. But both teams really starting to figure it out. New Zealand, under pressure, under the pump, have come through to bring it back to nines. can imagine their defense would be really fired up right now, knowing that they scored 5 breaks earlier in the game. Zig theory. What could be going through their minds right now?
I think right now, they've just got to try and stay calm, stick to their vertical stack. I think we've seen most success from Zig Theory when they're playing against match defenses. They haven't had a lot of answers for the Chicks zone, so they have an opportunity to play some vertical, isolate their really athletic cutters, take advantage of maybe a slight athletic mismatch they have across the board. That should deliver them success. And they are running maybe slightly downwind. So the wind is predominantly going across the field away from the camera with a slight angle towards the right.
Looks like Zig Theory are playing all their cards at this point. They've got all their big handlers on, all their big cutters. So I expect to see some plays if they get stuck whatsoever between their handlers. We're going to be seeing some big hucks. So hopefully we see some big grabs, some big blocks. An exciting last point to come.
Camuso with the pull, sends it downfield.
I believe the pull lands in. We've got Middleton straight away to Chch. Back to Middleton, back to Chch. Working it through the zone between the handlers. Back to Middleton, back to Chch. Nice one through the cup to Enting Hawk. Back to Chch. They've moved it up really fast here, Zig Theory. Got a call.
The Chicks playing a zone this point, and so far it hasn't slowed down Zig Theory at all. Let's see if they can clamp down, put a bit more pressure on like they did earlier in the game.
Enting Hawk tapping the disc in, back to Middleton, back to Enting Hawk. Looking to just keep the disc moving here, back to Thompson, Enting Hawk. Really fast moving, Thompson, Enting Hawk. Really nice movement through the middle here. The wind's not troubling them at all whatsoever. Thompson got the disc. The zone has really started to clamp down here. Enting Hawk with the disc on that hard sideline. Middleton, strong thrower. Enting Hawk, New Zealand pushing him back a little bit. Middleton with the disc. They don't have a lot of cutters. They're just hoping on this handler movement, just popping it through the zone. Chch with the disc on the sideline. That cup is really set up now. The wing's pushed in. They know the wind's there. It's backing them. Middleton. Short 1 meter throw. New Zealand playing really well here. This is really good defense. Very short throw from Middleton to Thompson. I've used a little bit of extractor. I'm not sure what happened. So Middleton with the disc. Back to Enting Hawk. Nice dump. Thompson with the disc. Hard to get it off that half of the field. Oh, nice breakthrough. Back to Enting Hawk. Middleton. Chch in the middle of the field. Oh, huge dig.
Hold away. Gets the block. Predicts the quick handler movement and gets in front. Tio picking up. Looking for Camuso. Finds Camuso. Camuso's a big, powerful thrower. Goes, looks deep, but falls short.
Michaela getting up there. Looks to be Chch picking up the disc in the middle of the field. Looking to go quick, but nothing there as of yet. New Zealand crashing really well on those handlers that are pushing in. Middleton with the disc. Struggling to find an option here. Thompson on that downwind sideline. Back to Enting Hawk.
Oh, run through block. Short field turnover, just in front of the big mark. Holdaway looks like she'll pick up. This is a great opportunity for the Chicks. Setting up with 3 handlers out. Let's see what they can do. Working hard to get a dump off. Can't find Teo, can't find Holdaway. Finds Camuso, providing an outlet valve for the pressure there. Camuso looking at Holdaway. Teo goes up line. Camuso, this could be it. Catherine Teo takes the beautiful upline cut, gets the goal. 10-9. The Chch of Christchurch win over Zeke Theory. Though, is there a bit of discussion on the field?
Might be a bit of a discussion here to see if it affected the play at all, but it looks like we've got shaking hands now.
And that's game. Wow. What a dramatic first game of the day. What a way to start Nationals.
What a finish. That last point really just showed what AUC 2017 is going to be like for the rest of these 4 days, I reckon.
Yeah, I hope so. If that's an indicator of the quality and tightness of the matches we're going to see, we're in for a real treat. Zeke Theory had opportunities. They had the disc, maybe 10, 15 from the end zone. But the zone from Chch was just a little too good. And in the end, they're powerful throwers able to get the job done. And that was really a game of swings and momentum. In the first half, Zeke Theory went up 7-3, putting on four in a row. Chch brought it back, got five in a row of their own to take half, 8-7. And then straight out of half, Zeke Theory got a couple in a row. So it's been a game of momentum swings and defensive runs.
Real credit to New Zealand zone, though. I think it all goes to they were very aware. Their players who were in the cup, they realised what Zeke Theory were trying to do. They were just trying to pop it through with handlers. The short 2 metre throws, just work it up the field until they could find a way through that cup. And then just those two run through Ds when they really needed it most. They came through. And as mentioned, those powerful throwers just put it deep over Zeke Theory's defense and just blew it right open.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, that's game one wrapped up for you, ladies and gents. We'll take a quick break. But stay tuned. We've got a couple more cracker games coming up today, both on this stream and the other. So we look forward to keeping you company.